This video shows you how to work with the Trellis Container in Qlik Sense. You can use the Trellis Container extension to show a trellis chart based on a master visualization. The trellis chart shows a grid of the same chart for different dimension values. You can use the trellis chart to compare metrics for different groups of data. You can create a trellis chart on a sheet you are editing. In Custom Object, select Visualization Bundle and drag a Trellis Container object onto the sheet. Add the dimension that you want to use as the grid dimension. In this example, we use Category Name. Select which master visualization to show under Appearance, Trellis Options by opening the Base Visualization drop-down menu and selecting one of the chart options, in this case, Scatterplot. The chart is not displayed because it contains too many values, so we are going to exclude the null values. You will now see a grid of charts, each based on the grid dimension you selected. You can select different ways to display your trellis. In this case, we are going to copy and paste the trellis container that we have just created, and then we can change the output by selecting line chart as the base visualization. In mobile view, the trellis is collapsed into slide mode, showing one chart at a time. You can also set this option as default by turning on the slide mode option. As you can see, you can now view one chart in greater detail and scroll between the other charts to compare. You can set minimum and maximum values for the y-axis in your trellis charts. In this example, the maximum value has been set in the combo chart master visualization using a scripted expression. If we create a trellis container and select product category as the dimension, and we set the master visualization to combo chart, the trellis will show a combo chart for each dimension value, and the maximum value has been calculated accordingly for each category. With trellis containers, you can also use advanced mode to specify where to insert set analysis and dimension values in the master visualization. In this map chart, we have added a formula that acts as a placeholder, which will be automatically replaced in the trellis chart by the corresponding values. In this example, the map will be colored based on the cost of sales value. Now we are going to create a trellis chart, and we are going to include in it the map chart master visualization that contains the placeholder. To activate advanced mode, you must turn on the advanced mode option. You will see a list of the placeholder values that you can use. As you can see, the trellis chart is now displaying a map for every category, and each map is colored by the cost of sales. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.